the second portion of this, we have 5 of the 7 students that actually participated in the mural project, and they're going to give their impressions of the process, the challenges of the project, the satisfactory moments of the project, and the overall outcome. So please welcome Carole Parker, Alexis Sammler, Kate Hochbrueckner, Roberta Gaino, and Sarah Beehler.
My name is Carole Parker. I'm a senior here at the College of Brockport, and I'm pursuing a double major in English with a creative writing track and arts for children as a visual arts specialty. And I am also in the Childhood Inclusive Education Program to become a certified teacher for grades 1 through 6. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the process. And as part of the process, there was, you know, the planning phase. And many of our thoughts and ideas were incorporated. And he asked us in the beginning, what do you see? And we were just initially when we went to the mall. And then throughout the middle of the phase, he would kind of take us over and say, what do you see here? Where do you see this coming out? And he would take what we had to say and incorporate it into the piece further. And then throughout the process, we would react to the piece. So initially, we were going to show a lot of the bricks, but then we decided to paint over it with the color and not have a natural brick behind it. So we would react to a lot of the shapes that were there. So there was a lot of movement involved when we would paint with the rollers and the brushes. And he would want a lot of the different images to come out of the existing shapes in there. And we used a lot of unfamiliar techniques and tools, such as spray paint and actually spraying water onto the mural as we went along to kind of blur the brush strokes. And we also used, you know, things like chalk reel to get fine lines, and parachute cloth, which we used on the Hartwell mural. So we kind of learned through this that process, it takes time. There wasn't a time when we would go there and we'd be working the whole entire time. We might just be sitting there and he goes, I don't have anything for you to do right now. So we had to get used to having downtime, but being okay with that. That we had a half hour to be there, and it was okay to have that downtime. But then some days we would show up, and he would say, paint that blue, paint that red, paint that black and white, and we would have a lot of stuff to do. And there was one day where 3 of us were told to take 3 cans of spray paint and go to the parachute cloth that we had already prepared, which is a portable type canvas that we had already prepped. And it was an outside location, and we were told to just go crazy. And we didn't ask for any other directions after that. We just went there, and we had no idea how to use spray paint, and we just went crazy. He goes, just send a picture of what you have completed to me at the end, and I'll give you some feedback. And all he said was, super fresh. So that's all I needed. I was very excited that I had the ability to do this, and the rest of us did too. And we were all very worried about deadlines. We go, it's only 3 weeks, are we going to be able to complete this? But he did not worry about it at all. He knew that the right person would show up at the right time. And he never would be, you know, too worried about the Hartwell mural. He gave us a lot of freedom on that. So that was kind of our own piece that we could work on, which was really nice. And he trusted us to complete it. We even worked on it after he was gone and sent him the pictures at the end. And he gave us the approval at the end and said, great, I love what you did. So it was really fantastic.
My name is Alexis Sammler, and I'm a sophomore, and my major is English. I was enrolled in Brockport last fall, but recently I transferred to Geneseo, but I wanted to come back and talk to all of you about this. So one of the most challenging parts of this project was getting everyone together to work at the same time, because we all had such varying schedules. However, we worked in clustered groups at a time, and it gave us opportunities to work one-on-one with Pose and learn from his style. His creative process stemmed from his intuition and instincts, so many of us had to rediscover our own creative process to be more in sync with the way he worked. And though it was nerve-wracking at first to get a project that did not have a concrete outline, many of us began to relax and trust in Pose's work style, which was very mellow. And as we progressed into this project, we began to open our minds to brainstorming together and helping out where and when we could. It was difficult for many of us because we had a limited amount of time due to our class schedules to commit with Pose, but we wanted to be engaged with this project, so we all found a time to stop by the site and work when we could. Pose was a really gracious artist who truly listened to what we had to say. And though it was difficult at first to work with a new medium of spray paint on such a large surface, we learned to react to what we added little by little, and we would step back and look at what we had. And the project was life-changing because we got to see a brick wall transform before our very eyes, and all of us got to be part of such a beautiful project.
Hi everyone, my name is Kate Hochbrueckner, and I'm a sophomore here at Brockport in the BFA program with a concentration in ceramics and a graphic design minor. And I'll be speaking about what it was like to work with Pose. To put it plainly, it was awesome to work with Pose. He's just such an amazing guy, and it was awesome to have the opportunity to work with a professional graffiti artist. He's such a fascinating and talented guy and an inspiration to never give up. One of the most important things that we learned from him was to follow your dreams and you can achieve them. Even if things seem to be falling apart, you can find a way. It was also fascinating to watch him work and just to observe how he processes everything. He seemed to do everything with such ease, and he never worried about deadlines. He knew the work would get done and that everything would fall into place, and he just trusted the process. It was truly amazing to be engaged in and give and take feedback while we worked. He was very patient, and even if we made a mistake, he was very forgiving and helped us learn and correct our mistakes. He is such a skilled and professional artist, and he always considered our opinions. I remember one day when Pose was working on the black and white section on the tunnel mural, he had stepped back to ask us what we thought. And I believe it was Alex, Lexi, and I that were working at the time. And Lexi said that she saw yoga poses and a yin and yang feeling happening in that section. And Pose felt that was really interesting because it was just completely spontaneous how that happened. His blatant answer was that he was just making designs that looked cool. I love when things happen like this spontaneously, just because it shows how amazing our brains can be, especially as artists. Pose always had so much energy, and even after a long day of school, we would come by and his energy would be contagious, and we were just ready for the next task.
I'm Roberta Guido, and I'm a senior BFA in dance, so I'm like, so I'm going to be talking about the most satisfying parts of this project. There were tons of satisfying parts of being in this project, as you can tell. One of them was seeing the sections of the project kind of come together, and as you can tell, there was a lot of uncertainty when things were happening. There's a lot of things happening at once, generally, and to see it all come together at the end is pretty cool, and to know that we had a part in that, and could leave and come back during the process and see something new just show up was really watching Pose just make stuff with spray paint was pretty amazing. We often found that he would listen to our opinions, and he'd actually ask for them, and then listen, and then talk about it with us, and then go back to whatever he was doing. So getting to actually influence his ideas was really satisfying. For example, Alexis, who is not here, but Alexis mentioned that there should be a fish at one point, and he just did it like right after that. So seeing our ideas come to life through a really skilled artist was exceptional. He gave us a ton of freedom in the Hartwell mural, and as Carol said, there was a few that were just told, go crazy, and he let them do whatever they wanted. And really challenging and using our artistic abilities to an end goal together was really great. He also taught some of us how to use spray paint, and we didn't realize how hard that would be at the beginning, I think, because most of us had not used spray paint. And by the end of it, it really, the whole project, we had a lot more appreciation for his work because of the amazing things he can do with just a spray can and how hard it is to do that. So we ended up with an appreciation of his skill. The most satisfying part for me was when students would go by the tunnel and start giving compliments to what we've been making. At the beginning, there was a lot of people that seemed visibly displeased that we were there or in their way, or just ignored us altogether. And I would remember hearing people like act like we weren't there and say, "What is this?" Like, or and we were trying to give an answer, or we wouldn't really say, "Well, we're painting," and they ask, "Well, why? And why does anyone do art?" I guess. It started to come together, and people started to actually respond to the work and think it was really awesome and say, "Keep going, keep up the good work." And that part became very, very satisfying. I really appreciated the chance to revoke and educate the campus audience and make a good impression on our community as a whole.
My name is Sarah Beehler, and I am a double major in art and arts for children, and I'm graduating this year, I'm a senior, and I'm going to kind of wrap things up and kind of talk about the outcome. Having the opportunity to work with Pose was amazing, and meeting everyone here is something we'll never forget. All together, we'll each have individual moments that we'll remember, but we learned so much and really gained some great skills from being a part of this collaborative project. Some important things that we learned was working together to achieve one goal and being patient through a collaborative and collective process. Also, being able to let the process and intuitive nature lead the way. And I know some of us had some trouble letting go of control when it comes to creating, including me. But this project really opened our eyes. We learned to trust and rely on each other's artistic skills, which really allowed this mural to exceed everyone's expectations. Pose influenced us through a zen-like nature, just letting us relax and have the artwork come to us as the process unfolded. And we'll be able to walk away with confidence and growth in our artistic abilities, along with the experience of being involved in a large-scale mural. This amazing mural brings life to the campus and college environment. As students walk around the campus, you can see a color palette and imagery that some portion of it, any faculty, student, or faculty staff can relate to. As each of us graduate, we get to leave knowing that we were able to leave our mark as artists on the campus for people to look at for years to come. We'll be able to walk through campus and see a piece of work that we participated in, where I met some amazing people and worked with a medium that wasn't too familiar with us. Pose came here with the intention to leave a legacy. And at the start of the project, little did we know we would do. We really appreciate being given this opportunity.
Does anyone have questions for the young artists?
I'm curious if your experience working on the murals in Tull and in Hartwell, similar to John Emily's experience in that pose we just sent him, deciding he was going to paint in each show up at one of these three sites, and it was up to you whether to catch up with them or how did that work?
It was sort of similar in that some days we'd be working on the wall and then other days we'd be working in Hartwell. And a lot of of the time it was if he has anything to do in the tunnel and he was working, it was just him that needed to work on it, he would say, okay, go work on the Harwell mural, because that's something that we could do on, he was trusting us to do on our own. The Tuttle murals were all him and his friends from Rochester. So, and that happened in the last day of the entire thing. And they just painted for like 14 hours straight. And I got to stop over at the very end and it was just like, you did this all in one day. And that's amazing. If you've seen them, they're amazing. And I just remember thinking like, well, everybody that goes to Tuttle is going to have like a surprise tomorrow.
We also have to like rely on each other a lot. So even if like he wasn't there, we could text each other. Like, oh, are you here? Oh, are you there? What's going on? And you're really more on that than maybe just meeting up with him.
And he would respond to us if we asked him directly where he was.
And sometimes we would just spontaneously visit and just watch him paint. And I would just sit there for hours at a time watching him. And he would just ask me what I thought about it. And then he would elaborate on that. So it was cool to just him being spontaneously around and just commenting on it.
So do you guys actually see, I mean, what percentage, I guess, of the work is yours? Like, are you able to walk by each of the pieces and say, you know, I worked on this? Or is it sort of covered, you know?
I think I only remember. I did a lot of background on the art, but I think there's other people that did way more background on the tunnel than I did.
I was proud of my green verses. So I got one perfect verse in it. Look at that.
That's me. Well, that's just it. You can walk up and see, and yeah. You know, you can show people, I did this.
Yeah, like I got to do the rocks. Like I was allowed to spray paint the rocks, and that was probably like my shining moment. Why didn't you spray paint? Like, and he like told me where to fill in, so I can like look right. And be like, I had to do that.
Yeah. That was the same for me. I worked on a little bit on the rocks and like the background, so I can walk by and be like, I did that. But I know for the Hartwell mural, we definitely get to work a lot more on that, so that we can be like, that's ours.
And that's pretty much 100% ours. He had maybe only about 5-10% of it. The rest of it was us, which was really nice.
Would you touch on for a moment the name of the Hartwell mural, please?
It's Unity, and it's, I don't know if I will be butchering the name, Emoji, or something like that. It's from Kwanzaa, from elements of Kwanzaa. And that kind of incorporates what we did, even though we were not all there at the same time, we were still united in finishing it as it was. And it also incorporated, since it's a studies area, it also incorporated the effort.
So does he sign his work? I mean, is it...
He did not?
No?
He does have a lot of signatures that are similar in a lot of his other works.
Mm-hmm.
The one in Tuttle, he used more of, I'd say, street-type art.
That's what I was wondering, yeah.
Mm-hmm. All the graffiti artists did their signatures for that, so you can see his writing, his lettering.
The FUWA crew actually came in from Rochester. They're a graffiti group that Pose originally started with when he was making art in Rochester. So they were recruited to come in and help him with the final stages and talk.
Plus he had some wall art with his name back when he attended school here.
Wow.
So those are some of them are still here.
Actually in the union on the second floor, he spray painted the OSAD mural.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
That's right down the hall from the Office of Student Disabilities.
I think that's his first mural.
Yeah.